Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Retro Channel. Now, I did have plans to do an Atari video or a Commodore video, but I'm, like most people, waiting on parts still. And I did do a lot of CoCo videos for Septandy, so I didn't really want to do another one. But I had this Color Computer 2 sitting around, which was going to be sort of a backup plan in case the Color Computer 1s didn't work out, and I was just going to clean this up, but when I powered it on to test if it was working, I was greeted with Color Basic and only 16K RAM, which isn't even enough to get the CoCo SDC to work, and I didn't really want to sit around programming my own games. The plan today is to try and put extended Color Basic in this and upgrade it to 64K of RAM, because you sort of need extended Color Basic in order to take advantage of the 64K. So we're going to crack this open and see what it looks like inside. I haven't really researched how to do this upgrade. I'm just kind of going to wing it and hope for the best. Okay. Alright, so things are a little different to the CoCo one, but not that different. This socket here, I dare say, is where our extended Color Basic would normally go. And it's a 24 pin socket, so I think what I'll be able to do is burn an EEPROM with extended Color Basic, if I can find it online, just using the TL866 Mini Pro programmer, and then I'll just need an adapter because the EEPROM is 28 pin, these are only 24, but you can adapt them to fit in a 24 pin socket, so I'll have to build one of those up. And the other thing I see is this must be our RAM here, which are the NEC D416C2, which I assume are just 16K by 1 bit, so 8 bits, 16K in total. So we need to replace those with 4164s, which should be pretty easy because they're all socketed as well. And I'm guessing somewhere on the board are going to be jumpers to set between 16 and 64K. Oh yeah. So there's one over here, which is actually just a couple of solder points. So I guess we'll have to put a little bodged wire across there. There's quite a bit of empty stuff around here. I'm not sure what circuit was supposed to go there. That little IC is labeled IC18. Well, the silk screen for that IC, if it was there. I think this is the board number, so 2026 1027. Like I said, I haven't researched CoCo 2s at all. I'm just going to wing it. What's going on down here? Oh, okay. So there's some stuff going on down here. It looks like there's little jumpers and there's a little note saying 16K. So it's like a ferrite bead. But yeah, there's three jumpers across the 16K. So I guess we remove them and put the jumpers across 64K instead. And I'm not sure if it's going to be, it probably is going to be like the CoCo one where we have to snip out one of these caps. But I guess we'll get to that. We'll check some voltages because these being 16K by 1 bit, they probably use 12 volts and minus 5 or minus 12 and plus 12 and plus 5. And 4164s pretty much only use plus 5 volts. So yeah, we don't want to send 12 volts into the wrong pin of a 4164. Anyway, first things first, let's build an adapter, and I guess I'll have a look online and make sure I can actually find a copy of the extended Color Basic ROM. So I'll do that. All right, so I did manage to find the extended Color Basic ROM on what looks like a Russian website. There's quite a lot of other stuff on here. There's Commodore stuff and Apple stuff. I'll put a link to the website in the description of this video. I'm not the owner of this website, so I don't know if there's any copyrighted material. I mean, I guess technically Color Basic or extended Color Basic is copyrighted, but I don't think anyone's going to be too concerned. And I did build up the little adapter, which I'll also link to down below on how to build one of these. Alternatively, you can order little PCBs that you just basically stick a 28 and a 24 pin socket to, which is a lot easier than trying to bend pins and fiddle with tiny little wires. But that's ready to go. And we've got the Mini Pro ready, so I'll stick this in. This is a 27C64 EEPROM, so it's basically 64 kilobit, which is 8 kilobytes, which should be perfect for what we need to do. First things first is just to do a blank check, make sure there's nothing already on there. Okay, yep, that's clear. Let's open this up. Yeah, it looks right. It's actually got in the ASCII code extended Color Basic 1.1, copyright 1982 Tandy, under license from Microsoft. So I guess we could change that text if we wanted to, but let's not fool around with it just yet. Just in case. All right, so that's loaded up. All we need to do is programming verified, program successful. I always like to do one extra verify just in case. Yep, cool. So that's it. Let's get it stuck in the computer. And hopefully I've wired this correctly as well. There's a few things that could go wrong here, but what the hell? First thing that could go wrong is me trying to put the IC the wrong way around. Yeah, always make sure you line up your notches. Hopefully I don't break this. I'm trying to put this in. Okay. Stick this in here. Ooh, actually that cap is going to get in the way. Luckily we don't need these pins. I might just shorten them. And little bits of pins have just gone flying around the room. Ooh, crunchy. All right. Let's power it up and see if it works. All right, fingers crossed. Hey, extended Color Basic 1.1. Sweet. Let's have a look at that. Oops. Help if I could type. Have a look at that memory. Oh, bloody hell. Used to the crappy chiclet keys. Not used to a half-decent keyboard. I say half-decent. All right, so we've got 8K of memory. I think that's because the extended Color Basic also gets loaded into RAM, so it takes another 8K from the 16K that we had. So, but that's a good start. At least we've got extended Color Basic installed and my adapter worked. So I'll tape over that little window just so it doesn't erase itself. All right, let's poke around at some voltages. So there is minus 5 on pin 1. And 12 volts over there. That's ground. That's plus 5. So, yeah, if we put 4164 RAM in here, it will definitely cook. So I think what needs to be done is to connect these jumpers and disconnect the other ones. Just have a look, see if we can find any voltages on these little jumpers. There's 5 volts there and 12 volts there. That jumper's got 12 volts across it. Oh, okay, that's why there's 12 volts there, because this jumper is connected to this little pad. Right, so we'll cut all that out and put jumpers in for the 64K designation. Where's that other one? Over here. Yeah, once again, that's got 5 volts sitting on it. So we'll cut these old ones out and hook up all the new ones and obviously pull this RAM out and see what happens. Disconnect the power just in case. Let's just be able to just snip that off. Ooh. Try not to damage the board. Okay, that's like glued down. Alright, that's separated. That's separated. Let's pull these out. I still don't have a chip puller for these little dips yet. Other stuff that's waiting to arrive. With the whole pandemic thing, things are taking a lot longer than usual. And even these don't really want to come out that easy. Get out. What I should try and use is try and use this. These are for like the PLCC, like similar to the quad flat packs, so those big square chips with the fine pitch pins, but it should work for these too. Yeah, that's better. The ideal tool for the job, but better than a screwdriver, I guess. Alright, let's just power it on again. See what voltages are on those sockets now. Nothing on pin 1. Shouldn't be much on these. Nothing on pin 8 or 9. These are all data and address lines, so they're all doing their own thing. Right, so nothing on the voltage rails. So obviously we need to hook up these jumpers, so let's do that. All right, so I pulled the board out. I removed all the original jumpers and installed some pin headers. Unfortunately, the The little jumpers to go over the pin headers don't fit because they're spaced too far apart on the board. But there was quite a bit of super glue, as I mentioned earlier, around this area. And it seems to be around some of the other parts of the board as well, which is kind of annoying. Yeah, didn't want to budge when I tried to desolder the original stuff. I cut the bypass caps off. So swapped them around, cleaned everything up. And now we have our full 32K, which is actually 64K, but it doesn't display it. And yeah, I played with the EEPROM just for fun, because why not? So yeah, happy days. I'm gonna plug in the Coco SDC and finally fire up some decent games on this thing. We now have a Coco 2 with extended color basic and 64K RAM, so a very capable machine. And yeah, as always, thanks for watching. I will be doing some Commodore and Atari stuff, as I mentioned, which I did start on many months back, so hopefully that'll be coming up soon. But until then, don't forget to hit subscribe, share it around, like, dislike, leave me a comment, and I will catch you in the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye.